Good morning. Today we want to see about the MOSFET as feedback amplifier. We will wait for other students for 1 minute. Until that, we will revise our previous session. In previous session, we have studied about MOSFET as diode, MOSFET as switch, MOSFET as active resistor. Then we have seen about current sink, current source, and the current mirror. So we can use MOSFET as a switch, because if you are using MOSFET as a switch instead of the switch, then there is a small amount of leakage current. We can use MOSFET as resistor, active resistor, because the resistor is a passive element, and as compared to the MOSFET, resistance is higher in size, larger in size. It is required large space area. So instead of resistance, we can use MOSFET as load resistance. So we will require small amount of area on IC. As there is a small amount of area required, there is a less power dissipation as compared to the passive resistor. So we can neglect the use of heat sink, because as there is a low power dissipation, power is dissipated in the form of heat. So वहाँ पे जो heat generate हो रही है वो कम हो रही है. That's why we can use MOSFET as active resistor. Then we have seen about we can use MOSFET as diode. If you are shorting drain terminal of MOSFET with gate terminal, then we can use MOSFET as diode. And if you compare MOSFET with simple diode, simple means PN junction diode, then we will see in PN junction diode, current will flow only because of majority carrier. It means what? Here current will flow only in one direction. But MOSFET is a bipolar. There are two junctions. So here current will flow because of majority as well as minority carrier. And if you compare MOSFET with PN junction diode, then PN junction diode is only current control device, but MOSFET as diode can be used as current control, voltage control device. Akshay Thorat, please mute yourself. और ये जो line draw किए हैं, वो line Akshay Thorat line erase कर दो, screen मत share करो तुम्हारा. Okay, so screen दिख रहा है सभी को? प्रणाली, my screen is visible. Today's class. Okay, so then we have seen about we can use MOSFET as current sink, current source. Current sink means what? If it is absorbing some amount of current, then we can say here we are using MOSFET as current sink. And if current is produced, then we can say we can use MOSFET there as a current source, means we can generate amount of current. If you we have already studied about current sink, current source, current mirror. So current sink mein humne kya dekha hai, if the value of V out is less than VGG minus VTH, at that time current is not a good source of MOSFET, is not a good source of current. It means what? Here we are not getting constant value of current, because current will increases if the value of V out is less than VGG minus VTH. And if the value of V out will be greater than VGG minus VTH, then MOSFET is working in a saturation region. So we can use MOSFET as current sink, because there we will get constant value of current. And in current source, we have seen if the value of V out, if the value of V out is less than VGG plus VTO, मतलब VGG plus VTO से यदि V out का value कम है, at that time we are getting MOSFET in saturation region and we are getting constant value of current. So we can use their MOSFET as a current source. And if value of V out will reaches, V out is nothing but VDS. So if value of V out will reaches greater than VGG plus VTH, at that time MOSFET is not a good source of current, because there we will not get MOSFET in saturation region. So here we cannot use MOSFET as a current source. But jab V out ka value VGG plus VTH se kam hai, VGG plus VTH se kam hai, at that time we can use MOSFET as a current source. Then we have seen current mirror. Current mirror is nothing but if we are giving any input source at the MOSFET and again we are getting the same value at the output, then we can call this concept as a current mirror. It means what? We will get constant value of current at the output. Here we have to use two MOSFET. It means what? If M1 is giving voltage source to the second transistor, this is nothing but M2, and we will get voltage source from first transistor and its output is similar with first transistor, then we can say we can use MOSFET as a current mirror because it is giving same amount of current. Matlab wahan jo output current hoga, that will be equal, that will be in proportion with input current. And these values are depend only on aspect ratio. These are not depending on other energy sources. Matlab unke jo values hai, these are depend only on W by L. Aspect ratio is nothing but the dimensions of the channel. W means width and L means length. So their values are depending only on aspect ratio. In today's session, we have to study about MOSFET as feedback amplifier. So firstly, we will see about feedback. Feedback is nothing but if we are giving any response from output to the input, then we can call this as a feedback. Matlab hum output se yadi input mein fir se response de rahe hain ki hame output jo hai increasing mil raha hai, decreasing mil raha hai, constant mil raha hai, how it is proportion with input. If we are giving response, then we can call this as a feedback. And amplifier, we know we can use transistor as amplifier. Why? Because transistor is an active component. And here we can use transistor to amplify, to control the value of input energy sources. So we can use MOSFET as feedback amplifier. If you see, this is the circuit diagram, how we are using MOSFET as amplifier. Actually, here I am not giving any MOSFET. I am just showing how we are classifying amplifier, on which components we can classify amplifier. If you see, we can use this as a source. We can use this circuit as an amplifier. This is exact same circuit with this. This is exactly similar. You can see here, only I have changes the name. Why? Because this is the input resistance we are giving to the amplifier. And what is this? This is the load resistance, which we will get at the output. Load resistance kahan hota hai? Output mein hota hai. Akshay Thorat, okay. Akshay and Harshita, you have not joined audio, so tumhe mera awaaz hi nahi aa raha hoga. Audio join karna chahiye sabhi ne. Okay, haan. So if you see this example, what is we are using? We are using here this component, this circuit as a source. It means what? They are giving input source to this amplifier, and we are checking the output at this resistance. So we are calling this resistor as a load resistance. For example, if we want to increase the input resistance, if we want to increase this resistance of this amplifier, amplifier matlab kya? Wo amplify karega. Jo bhi input hum denge, usko wo hume output mein amplify karke dega. So if here we are giving this source and this source is giving input resistance, and by using this amplifier, if we want to amplify the value of this input resistance Ri. We can connect external resistance. We can connect this external resistance at the output. As the second example, if we want, again, if we are taking another example, what we have to do? If we want to reduce the output voltage, if we want to reduce the output voltage, VO from IO RL. IO is nothing but output current, and RL is nothing but load resistance. What we have to do? If we have to decrease the value of output resistance, we can connect resistance across output terminal. Hum kya kar sakte hai? If yahan pe yadi hamare paas ek resistance hai R0, if we are having here one output resistance RO, and what we have to do? We have to decrease the value of voltage. Then what we can do? We can use load resistance in parallel. If we are using load resistance in parallel, what will happen? The value of load resistance will absorb some amount of voltage, some amount of potential, and we will get here decrease in voltage. It means what? The amount of output voltage will be decreased. It means what? We can use amplifier to increase the value or to decrease the value. It means what? But these models result in wastage of useful signal. To obtain desired property without wastage, hum kya kar rahe hain yahan pe? If tumhe output ka resistance, output ka voltage kam karna hai, to hum kya kar rahe hain usme aur ek parallel resistance use kar rahe hain. So instead of doing this, what we can do? We can, here we are getting wastage, so what we can do? We can give feedback, matlab output ka jo response hai we can give to the input. So there is no need to use external component. So here the component amount will get reduced. What we can do? Here we are getting wastage of components by applying external components, by giving external component. So we can use here feedback circuit. So if we see here, this is the classification of amplifier, and these things are depending on the value of input resistance and the value of source resistance. This depending on these two things. So we will see here, amplifier are divided into four types. Amplifier are divided into four types: voltage amplifier, current amplifier, transconductance amplifier, and the trans resistance amplifier. Amplifier jo hai wo four types mein divide hota hai, and these are depending on the value of output resistance of source. Ye jo yahan ka source hai, ye jo source hai, we are using this circuit as a source, we are using this circuit as an amplifier. These two circuits are exactly similar, but what we are saying, ye jo source hai uska output resistance ye hai, and ye jo input resistance yahan ka tha, we are giving at the output source ke. But here we are not saying it is a load resistance, we are saying it is the input resistance which we are giving to the amplifier. Iska jo output resistance hai, we are giving it to the amplifier as a input resistance. So what we can say here, this is the source output resistance, this is the source output resistance, and Ri is nothing but it is the input resistance of amplifier, because this circuit is a amplifier. Depending on the values of source resistance and input resistance of amplifier, amplifier is divided into four types, and these types are voltage amplifier, current amplifier, transconductance, and the trans resistance. If the value of, just wait for a minute, ma'am, I am not getting your voice because you have not joined audio. Just wait a minute, I am putting one message. Okay, so what we are saying, the value the classification of amplifier are depending on the values of the source output resistors and the input resistors of amplifier. If the value of input resistance of amplifier is higher than source resistance, if the value of input resistance of amplifier is higher or greater than output resistance of source, then we can say this amplifier is a voltage amplifier. Kab jab ye ri ka value rs se zyada hai. Ri is nothing but input resistance of the amplifier. And if the input resistance of amplifier is greater than output resistance of source, then we can use this circuit as voltage amplifier. We can use this circuit as a voltage amplifier. Exactly opposite for current amplifier. Current amplifier mein kya ho jayega? Ri ki value kam ho jayegi, rs ki value zyada ho jayegi. It means what? If the value of output resistance of source is greater than input resistance of amplifier, this is nothing but Ri, then we can say this equivalent circuit we can use as a current amplifier. Kab? Jab Rs ka value zyada hai. Kisse? Input resistance of amplifier. Accordingly, the output resistance RO, the output resistance will be greater than RL. Yahan pe kya hoga? These are nothing but amplifier. It means what? The output resistance of amplifier is greater than load resistance. At that time, we can use this equivalent circuit as a current amplifier. So, current amplifier mein kya kya condition hai? RS will be greater than RI. And RO will be greater than RL. Then we can use this circuit as a current amplifier. Or if RI is greater than RS, RI is greater than RS, and this RL is also greater than this RO, exactly opposite with a current amplifier. Yadi wahan pe RI ka value zyada hai RS se aur RL ka value RO se zyada hai, then we can use this equivalent circuit as a voltage amplifier. Now we have to see about transconductors and the transresistors. Ab transconductance mein kya hai? Jo first condition hamare voltage amplifier ke liye thi. First condition kya thi? Ri will be greater than Rs. So if we have to use this equivalent circuit as a transconductance amplifier, then the value of input resistance of amplifier will be greater than output resistance of source. First condition same, but second condition will exactly opposite. Wahan pe kya tha? RL ka jo value tha wo RO se zyada tha. To yahan pe kya ho jayega? RL value will be less than RC. RI का वैल्यू RS से ज्यादा है बट RL का वैल्यू RO से कम है. एट दैट टाइम वी कैन यूज दिस इक्विवेलेंट सर्किट एज अ ट्रांसकंडक्टर्स एम्पलीफायर. नाउ वी हैव टू सी अबाउट द ट्रांसरेजिस्टेंस. ट्रांसरेजिस्टेंस में क्या हो जाएगा? करंट एम्पलीफायर का फर्स्ट इक्वेशन. करंट एम्पलीफायर का फर्स्ट इक्वेशन क्या था? RS वैल्यू विल बी ग्रेटर देन RI. सो सेम, इफ द सोर्स रेजिस्टेंस means what? Output resistance of source is greater than input resistance of amplifier. RS is greater than RI. Or second condition kya thi wahan pe? RO is greater than RL. Second condition kya thi wahan pe? If RS is greater than RI and RO will be less than, exactly opposite with a current amplifier. Second condition jo hai yahan pe opposite rahegi. RS will be greater than RI, but value of output resistance will be less than RL. Then we can use this circuit, equivalent circuit, as a trans resistance. So here we can classify this amplifier into four types depending on the value of output resistance of the source and input resistance of the amplifier. If the value of RI is greater than Rs and value of Rl is greater than Ro, then we can use this equivalent circuit as a voltage amplifier. And if the value of Rs is greater than Ri, first condition kya tha, voltage mein Ri ka value isse zyada tha, exactly opposite, dono condition exactly opposite. यहाँ पे क्या हो जाएगा, the value of output resistance of a source will be greater than Ri and Ro will be greater than Rl. Then we can use this equivalent circuit as a current amplifier. And if again voltage amplifier की first condition, if Ri is greater than Rs and exactly opposite with voltage amplifier का second condition, if Rl is less than Ro, then we can use this equivalent circuit as a transconductance amplifier. अब current amplifier का first condition, if Rs is greater than Ri, if Rs is greater than Ri, and if the value of Rl will be greater than Ro, मतलब क्या हो जाएगा, if value of Ro is less than Rl, then we can use this equivalent circuit as a transconductance amplifier. These are the four different types of the amplifier. Now we have to see about the feedback amplifier. If we are giving feedback, what we can do here, because instead of feedback we are using only amplifier, what is happening, if we have to amplify any input, at that time we have to connect external components at the load, at the output side, so we will require external components. That's why instead of wastage of the circuit, wastage of components, we can give feedback. So there are different types of the feedback amplifier, negative feedback, voltage series, voltage shunt, current series, current shunt feedback. These are actually we are giving here feedback. And we can use amplifier. If we are giving negative feedback, then we can call this as the feedback amplifier. और यदि वहाँ पे positive रहेगा, then we will see about the oscillator. But we will study these things in the next session. Today we want to see only about the feedback amplifier, where we are giving negative feedback. And these amplifiers are again divided into four types. These are the four types which we are depending. These are depending only on the value of input resistance of the amplifier and output resistance of source, and the values of load resistance and the values of output resistance. Same things we will require to differentiate this amplifier into the voltage series, voltage shunt, current series feedback, and current shunt feedback amplifier. These are the four different types we are using for the feedback amplifier. As you can see here, the name given. Feedback means what? If we are giving response from output to the input, then we can say, we can use this amplifier as a feedback amplifier. And if negative feedback, it means what? If output is out of phase with input, negative matlab kya? If we are giving positive sign wave and we are getting exactly 180 degree phase shift, opposite matlab kya? Hume ulta cos mil jayega sign ki jagah. At that time, what we can say? Output is opposite with input. This means what? We are getting their negative feedback. And voltage series, voltage shunt, current series, current shunt feedback, we will see 1/5. So feedback is nothing but in the feedback process, what we can do, we can process part of output, it's sampled and again given to the input. The feedback signal can be phase in or out of phase with original input signal. On depending this concept, feedback is divided into two types, positive and negative feedback. Positive means if the output of feedback is in phase with original input signal, then we can say we will get positive feedback. And if output of feedback is out of phase with original input signal, then we can say we will get negative feedback. So feedback is the process in which part of output signal, what will be the part? Here we will get voltage or we will get here current. So what we can do here? Feedback is defined as the process in which part of output signal, that will be voltage or current, it will be written back to the input. And amplifier that operates on principle of feedback. मतलब जब हम आउटपुट से फीडबैक इनपुट में दे रहे हैं उसके बाद जब एम्पलीफायर ऑपरेट हो रहा है देन वी कैन यूज एम्पलीफायर एज अ फीडबैक इट मींस व्हाट हियर आउटपुट वोल्टेज और आउटपुट करंट इज रिटन बैक टू द इनपुट एंड एम्पलीफायर विल ऑपरेट ऑन द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ दैट फीडबैक देन वी कैन यूज दिस सर्किट is equivalent circuit as a feedback amplifier. And there are two types of positive feedback and a negative feedback. There are two types of feedback. If the output signal, this is nothing but the feedback signal, is in phase with original input signal. Matlab, feedback signal or input signal dono phase mein hai, then we can say feedback is positive. However, if these two signals, these are nothing but feedback output signal and original input signal are out of phase. ये दोनों यदि out of phase, then we can use feedback as a negative feedback. Amplifier without feedback. It means what? If we are not giving feedback, we are giving input voltage to the amplifier, we are getting output voltage VO at the output. Then if we are calculating gain, gain is nothing but this is the ratio of output with input. If you are calculating voltage, voltage gain, that will be the ratio of output voltage with input voltage. It means what? If in any amplifier circuit, if you are not giving response of output from output to the input, then we can call this amplifier without feedback. The most important thing to understand from this figure is that output and input terminal are not connected with each other. And if we have to give the response from output to the input, then we have to connect output with input. But what we can say, these are not connected, these are independently working. It means what? This amplifier is not having any feedback. So if you are calculating the gain, AV equal to VO upon VI, output voltage upon input voltage. Or yadi yahan pe hum feedback de rahe hain, what will happen? We will get here positive or negative feedback. Kya ho jayega? Hume positive ya fir negative feedback mil jayega. Then we can use their sampling network, feedback network. We will see this diagram. You can see here. Now we have to see amplifier with feedback. So what we are doing here, we are using mixer. Why? Because what we have to do, we have to mix here response with input voltage. This circuit, a VI amplifier and VO, this is exactly similar with this. What I am doing, I am using before input voltage one mixer. Why? Because I have to mix the response of input and the response of फीडबैक. मतलब फीडबैक का जो है मुझे वो क्या करना है, फीडबैक इनपुट में देना है. एंड फॉर फीडबैक आई एम यूजिंग हियर फीडबैक नेटवर्क. वी कैन कॉल दिस एज अ बीटा. एंड दिस इज द इनपुट वोल्टेज, दिस इज द आउटपुट वोल्टेज एंड दिस इज द फीडबैक. फीडबैक वोल्टेज इज नथिंग बट वी कैन डिनोट VF. सो व्हाट वी कैन डू, इफ वी आर गिविंग फीडबैक विद एम्पलीफायर देन वी कैन ड्रॉ सर्किट डायग्राम as shown here. What I am giving, I am using here feedback network to give response from output to the input. Output ka response input pe lene ke liye. So we are using here sampling network. So you guys can refer this diagram. Here is the same amplifier which again A is being used along with mixer network, sampling network and the feedback network. Maine kya kiya hai, output we are getting It means what? Response of output. Some amount of response we are taking from the output, and that is sampling network will be taken to the feedback network and again given to the mixer. The voltage gain will be, so voltage gain वहाँ पे क्या था? Output voltage upon input. But यहाँ पे हम directly input दे रहे हैं क्या amplifier को? Output will be same. But we are giving here response as a feedback. So what will be? That is nothing but these things will be depending on this supply voltage. Vs. Vs is nothing but it is the input voltage as well as we are getting the response from output. Means what? Here gain with feedback will be VO upon Vs. Supply voltage or jo VO tha, this is nothing but the output voltage. This is the circuit diagram for amplifier with feedback. And now amplifier with feedback is divided into four types. These are nothing but voltage series, voltage shunt, current series, current shunt. And these things are again depending on the values of how it is depending with input and output relation. So amplifier with negative feedback. This is the same diagram I am drawing again. Same diagram here. What we are doing here? I am giving feedback. How we are giving? We are giving feedback from output to the input by using sampling network and by using the feedback network. You can see here, when I am giving here positive sign wave at the output, we are getting exactly output, exactly opposite. मतलब साइन भी है तो मुझे कॉस वेव मिलता है. मींस व्हाट? वी आर गेटिंग हियर नेगेटिव फीडबैक. ये फीडबैक जो है, यू कैन सी दिस इज द सप्लाई वोल्टेज एंड व्हाट वी कैन सी हियर द फीडबैक नेटवर्क इज एग्जैक्टली अपोजिट. ये फीडबैक का जो है, दिस इज अपोजिट विथ इनपुट. इट मींस व्हाट? वी कैन से दिस डायग्राम इज नथिंग बट एम्पलीफायर विथ अ नेगेटिव amplifier with negative feedback. So we will get gain equal to kya milta hai hame? Output voltage upon input voltage. Input is nothing but here supply voltage. This is the combination of input as well as the output. This is nothing but feedback. Matlab yahan pe tum Vs ko kya bol sakte ho? Vi plus Vf. Matlab feedback se jo mil raha hai aur input ka jo hai. But its reciprocal will be beta. ये जो feedback network है. So if you solve for beta, you will get beta equal to Vf upon V0. Exactly opposite with Vf upon V0. Because Vf is nothing but it is the feedback voltage. This is feedback voltage and Vo will be output voltage. If you are calculating this feedback factor, you will get Vf upon Vo. And if you are calculating gain, output feedback voltage gain, then that will be the ratio of output voltage with supply voltage. वहाँ पे क्या हो जाएगा तुम्हें? If you are calculating AV, you will get VO in numerator and in denominator you will get VO upon VS. VS मतलब the supply voltage. And that will depend on the value of VF. उसका वैल्यू किस पे डिपेंड है? फीडबैक वोल्टेज पे. सो हियर वी विल सी वी आर गेटिंग सप्लाई वोल्टेज दैट विल बी इन ऑपोजिट फेज विथ फीडबैक नेटवर्क. सो वी कैन से हियर वी विल गेट नेगेटिव फीडबैक. वी हैव टू सी फोर टाइप्स ऑफ नेगेटिव फीडबैक. वी विल सी इन नेक्स्ट सेशन. नाउ we will revise what we have seen today. In today's session we have seen we can use MOSFET as feedback amplifier. Why we can use MOSFET as feedback amplifier? Because if you are giving any output response to the input written back, then we can call the circuit as a feedback circuit. And we know we can use MOSFET as a switch when MOSFET will be in cutoff region or a linear region. And when MOSFET will be saturation region, we will get constant value of current. So we can use MOSFET as amplifier. हमें ये पता है, we have studied in first unit also. So now we have to see how we are using amplifier. So amplifier, these are depending on the value of output resistance of source and input resistance of amplifier, and depending on output resistance RO and the RL load resistance. How these are depending? Because this amplifier is divided into four types. इट मीन्स वॉट, हम वो वोल्टेज को एम्पलीफाई करने के लिए यूज कर रहे हैं, या वी आर यूजिंग फॉर करंट एम्पलीफायर, और वी आर यूजिंग टू एम्पलीफाई ट्रांस कंडक्टेंस और द ट्रांस रेजिस्टेंस. सो दिस वैल्यूज आर डिपेंडिंग ऑन रेजिस्टेंस. कैसे? आर एस, आर आई, आर ओ एंड आर एल पे डिपेंडेंट. इफ द वैल्यू ऑफ आर आई विल बी ग्रेटर देन आर एस and value of RL is greater than RO, then we can use this equivalent circuit as a voltage amplifier. And if the value of RS is greater than RI and RO is greater than RL, two conditions are exactly opposite with a voltage amplifier, then we can use this equivalent circuit as a current amplifier. And if the value of RI, first condition of voltage amplifier, if the value of RI is greater than RS but value of RL is less than RO, then we can use this equivalent circuit as a transconductance amplifier. And if the value of RS is greater than RI, first condition of a current amplifier, and second condition will exactly opposite with current amplifier. RS ka value RI se zyada hai but RO ka value jo hai it is less than RL, then we can use this equivalent circuit as a trans resistance amplifier. Ashish, please mute yourself. So we can use amplifier as voltage series, voltage shunt, current series, current shunt. These are depending on voltage concept and current concept. So if we are giving output response to the input, then we can call the circuit as a feedback circuit. It means what? Here the some part of output is returned back to the input, and this amplifier that operates on the principle of feedback will call as a feedback amplifier. If we are not giving output to the input, it means what? If we are not connecting response of output to the input, then we can say this is amplifier without feedback, and it's gain output voltage upon input voltage. And if you are giving any feedback, then we can use here sampling network, feedback network. Sampling means what? Here we are sampling the output voltage to get feedback. And that feedback will be provided with feedback network to the input by using mixer, and its gain will be VO upon VS. We will see these four types in next session. Thank you. Now I am taking your attendance. Feedback, amplifier, and oscillator. We will continue in next class. Any doubt you can ask me. You guys can leave now. Thank you.